Hey.
Here's a look at green juice.
Good morning, guys. Starting the day off with some green juice and some watermelon salad, as you guys just saw me make this morning.
Cool. Did you say watermelon salad?
Yeah, I called it watermelon salad because I put lime juice, basil, and mint
in it. I guess
it
is a salad. There's leafy greens in that.
Technically. It is a beautiful summer day. The sun is shining. So we decided instead of having breakfast inside, we're going to come to the local park and have breakfast outside. And there is nobody here. We have the whole park to ourselves. We're under this little gazebo thing. Also, happy Canada Day. Today is Canada Day, but it's actually tomorrow for us while I'm filming this. So all of you Canadians out there, happy birthday, Canada. And in celebration of summer and, you know, July 1st and the 4th of July for all of you guys in the US, I've decided to do a summer sale on my ebook. So if you use the code SUMMER at the checkout, at my website, link is in description, you'll receive 50% off of my ebook. My ebook is full of tons of things like juice recipes, smoothie recipes, lots of great things for the summer. I've got burgers in there, pizza, you know, all the good stuff that you can bring to little summer gatherings. So make sure you guys check it out. And also, I just want to say a huge thank you to all of you guys who have already purchased the book and are supporting me in that way. I really, really appreciate it, and it's so cool to see you guys recreating these recipes, making them for your families. It's just honestly so heartwarming to me. So yeah, I decided to do another sale, do a summer sale, get you guys in the mood for summer, eating some really good vegan food. So make sure you check that out. Link in description. Look at this watermelon salad.
Wow.
And it's organic watermelon too. I paid the big bucks for organic watermelon, guys. Green juice. As you guys, I don't know if you guys noticed, but we got a new juicer, and it's a cold press juicer, which means it's not a masticating, no, it is a masticating juicer. It's not a centrifugal juicer, which means it doesn't oxidize your juice as fast, and it, yeah, it's amazing. It's literally such a beast. There's barely any pulp that comes out of making all of this juice. It's amazing. Ugh, green nutrition.
You like it?
It's so good.
It's really good, isn't it?
This is like epitome of summer.
Gotta love summer. And green juice.
And me.
I was just gonna say, you know what I love more than watermelon?
Green juice?
Nope.
Me?
Yeah.
Quick thoughts. What are your thoughts on juicing in a nutshell, because I know we're gonna get a lot of questions that we're juicing.
Juicing is super beneficial for people who don't eat a lot of vegetables or even fruit. To get in that structured water, that high quality nutrition from like kale, cucumber, celery, stuff like that, it's really important. It has so much nutrients that your body needs. And like, our bodies are actually juicers itself.
We poop out all the fiber, and all of the liquid nutrition from all of that stuff goes straight into our cells. Mm-hmm. Basically just like the best form of like a supplement or a vitamin that you can take. We don't look at juices as a meal or a source of calories. We more so look at it as
a supplement.
Like, yeah, like a supplement. Yeah. We're juicing, like he said, we're juicing things that we don't eat a lot of. We don't eat a lot of celery and cucumber, you know, like we wouldn't have that for breakfast.
For us, we feel really good juicing.
Yeah, it makes us feel really good. And I'm sure I'll get a lot of questions on the model of juicer that we got. It's an Omega juicer. And I'll put an Amazon link in the description for the model that we have if you guys want to look at the specific one that we got. Look at, I just want to show you guys our scenery. It's literally just all green. Green. Green, green, green.
More picnic tables over there.
Green.
Cheers, McGears.
All right. right, so I want to show you how I make my kale salad. If you guys have been following me on Instagram, I've been posting that on my story quite a lot recently. And a lot of you guys have been asking for the recipe because it looks so delicious, because it is. So the ingredients that I'm going to be using is some fresh, delicious, nice and crispy kale, some cherry tomatoes, some mushrooms, and I have a cup of cooked chickpeas. So the first thing I'm going to do is chop up these mushrooms and add them to the bowl of chickpeas. So to this mixture, I'm going to make sort of like a little marinade with some spices and a little bit of maple syrup to kind of get everything coated. The spices that I use, I just use the spices that I enjoy, so you can kind of play around with this. I will leave a recipe link in the description down below if you guys want to follow this exactly, but I just kind of do what I have and what I enjoy. I'm gonna use a teaspoon and a half of garlic powder, about half a teaspoon of smoked paprika, a pinch of curry powder, and some salt and pepper. And then just a little drizzle of maple syrup. I'll measure it out so that I can be a little bit more specific. We'll say a teaspoon. That's just to help get the spices coated onto everything. And then mix it all up to make sure everything is nice and coated. And then we're gonna put it on a baking sheet and throw it in the oven. Okay, it needs a little bit more maple syrup. So like a teaspoon and a half. Okay, so now I want to give you a few tips. For those of you that may not like salads, they may not enjoy salads, especially kale salads, because I was there before too. I want to give you a few tips and tricks how to make yourself enjoy salads a little bit more. So we're going to do a few kale leaves. You don't want the big veiny parts in it. You just want the nice tender greens. It's literally bigger than my head. All right, so I have this huge bunch of kale. First tip is cut your kale up nice and small because nobody wants a big chunk of kale. That's not appetizing. Small pieces. Tip. Oh, I'm not in the frame. Tip number two is to massage your kale. You really gotta massage it, and you wanna massage it till it's nice and green and it's almost kinda like wilty, and that means that the oils are coming out of the kale and it's gonna make it a lot easier for you to chew. It's not gonna be as like hard. It's gonna be nice and soft. It's gonna have a better flavor. It's gonna be easy to digest. You gotta give your kale some TLC. See, that's very nice and dark and green, and it's also become like almost half the size. Tip number three is to make a very nice dressing. If you really enjoy creamy dressings, I'm a sucker for creamy dressings. When I first tried salad, I would only eat Caesar salad because it was nice and creamy and fatty and it really coats the leaves nicely. So I'm gonna make a creamy dressing using tahini. Last tip is top it with things that you really enjoy. I think crispy chickpeas make everything 3 billion times tastier, so they always go on the salad. Not to toot my own horn, but the salad's pretty darn good. And yes, I realize this is a massive portion. I do realize that, but I love it. And I've been eating huge salads. Like, haven't I been eating huge salads lately?
You have.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what it is. I go through like salad kicks and cravings, and I think now just because it's summer, I'm not craving like super dense heavy comfort food. I want more like light foods. Oh yeah, also I made some fries as well, just to have a little bit more substance. Sweet potato fries and regular fries.
I'm not really a fan of kale salad, so that's why I don't.
He's not a fan of anything that is the color green, unless it's a green juice.
No, I like green apples and celery, but it has that peanut butter on it. Like if the kale's really soft.
That's why you gotta massage your kale, friends.
It's almost there.
You wanna smell?
He's like, let me out of here.
Let me out. I'm going back to bed. Bye. All right, I'm in my comfy clothes, hair is up, and I am testing some stuff for dinner. These, I made these. Look at. I made this. Eh? What is this, you ask? It is a tortilla bowl. So these are flour tortillas, and then I just baked them. Baking them in these little ramekins, like so, and then they turn into little bowls. So I'm gonna make little taco bowls, and I thought that this would be such a fun idea. I think it's so cute for summer if you're like doing like a potluck or you're having people over and you make like these little taco bowls, and people, you can have like different like fillings, and then people can fill them with different things. And I've always wanted to try this, so I thought, you know, summer video, I thought it would be really fun to make. And yeah, these ones were like my little testers, so they didn't really turn out so hot, and I think I've kind of figured it out. You have to warm up the tortilla first, and then when you put it in the little ramekin dish, I took like this 1 cup measuring cup, and I just like pressed it down in the middle to make all the little like curves even. So hopefully these ones turn out a little bit better. And then I've got rice finishing up in here. I've got black beans that I cooked. We've got corn, avocado. We've got salsa and lettuce. And we're gonna make little taco bowls, and I'm so excited. Cute did these turn out. I'm so excited. They turned out so well, and these are so versatile.
That didn't do anything.
The light is coming in on you over
there.
Oh,
it's bouncing off the stove.
Okay, we have the lighting sorted. You can put whatever the heck you want in these, and if you guys want the recipe for them, I will link that in the description. I topped it off with a garlic tahini sauce and some guacamole.
Reminds me of a ventre sauté. Is that
no,
a ventre
sauté.
A ventre.
I was just gonna say, that's what kind of inspired me to make these little bowls. Was one of the restaurants that we ate at in LA had this really good tostada bowl.
I like tostada bowls.
So good, 10 out of 10. Would make again.
These are perfect, like, for presentation purposes. If you're gonna have like people over.
And just take a nice bite.
Do you have anything similar to this in your ebook? Just like a burrito bowl?
And I have nachos where you make your own nacho chips using tortillas. But yeah, guys, again, my ebook is on sale for the next week. I don't think I mentioned that at the beginning of the video, but today, for the next week, so you have 7 days to use the code SUMMER at checkout, and you will receive 50% off. Super good deal. There's over 100 recipes. There's everything in there, from juices, smoothies, there's grub food, tons of oatmeal recipes, dessert recipes, like everything. I got you all covered in there. You're set.
My favorite thing out of her ebook is the cheesecake. Mm. I don't even think I've seen someone make the cheesecake in the Facebook group yet.
Anyways.
Let us know what you guys are doing this summer too.
Yeah, we're working on our second book.
Wow. We're trying to get that done so we can enjoy the summer.
We've just been stuck in the house, which is why you've seen a lot of videos of us inside, because we don't really leave the house because we're always working, but...
Or at the gym.
Yeah, This second book is going to be super awesome. I'm really excited. For those of you that don't know, it's going to be an oat-focused book. Oat, like the grain, because I love oatmeal so much. Nothing that I think you guys are expecting, I think it's going to be just very different. That's kind of what we've been up to, but we're super excited for the summer. I hope you guys are too. Don't forget to check out the ebook sale link in the description and also in the pinned comment. And I think that pretty much wraps it up for today. If you guys want the recipes for the salad and for these, that will also be in the description. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video.
We'll see you in the next video.
Yeah. Bye.
Peace out, dudes.